Mort's Miniatures Vlog is filmed before a live studio Andy.
Hello world. Mort is using my music. The music you are hearing in this video, with one notable exception, is by Namtau. If you like to have something to listen to while you're painting your miniatures, Namtau also produces an audio story podcast called Lost Terminal. It's about a post-apocalyptic world told through the eyes of several self-aware artificial intelligences as they try to understand the world around them. Links to Lost Terminal and more of Namtau's work can be found in the description below.
Hi, I'm Mort. Welcome to another vlog. Let's take a look at some miniatures. First up, here's not one, not two, but three Plastic Skaven. And yeah, these three demonstrate a little bit of Skaven history, at least plastic models wise. This first one is from the original Warhammer Plastic Regiment set, and it's completely stock. The only bit of conversion work I really did to this was fitting him to a round base rather than the square base he would have come with, and I did a little bit of filing between the ears to make them more ear shaped. Originally that head was just kind of flat at the back and the ears just formed a single straight line. I think they look better this way. I'm quite pleased with the Skaven symbol I painted on his shield, freehand and everything. Yeah, nice little model this. This guy is of course an Advanced HeroQuest Skaven, again completely stock. Of course, I've painted a completely stock one of these before, which you've probably seen in a previous video. But this one, I've done in a red colour scheme, so that I could have one of each of these three generations in the same colour scheme, for comparison purposes. And this third one is one of the Skaven that came in Warhammer Quest, although it did also appear in other sets, including its own regiment set and 3rd edition talisman. This one, unlike the previous one I painted, is completely stock, including the shield. And talking of the previous one I painted, his sword got broken off, so I've replaced it with an Advanced HeroQuest Skaven sword. So now both his sword and shield come from an Advanced HeroQuest Skaven. Yeah, all in all I'm quite pleased with these three. I think the red colour scheme works particularly well on Skaven miniatures. Here's all three together in some ruins with Clanky Alpha Scale.
Die you will! Die, die, die!
This is a Bugbear from Citadel's AD&D range. Nice classic old school miniature this one. And according to this webpage here, it's Pose 1 Variant D. This Bugbear variant has a pointed beard, his hair is gathered into a top knot with a small bone through it, and a ponytail. His closed mouth has his tongue protruding on the left side. He has long ears without notches or earrings. His head looks slightly right, and he is armed with a spear in his right hand and a single-bladed axe with a back spike in his left. Not really much to say about this one, but yeah, I'm rather pleased with it. Didn't do any conversion work on it, it's completely stock. I thought it was a bit too big for the original base that came with him, so I decided to mount him up on a nice new 32mm round base. I think he fits a lot better on this base. Lots of nice details on these old models. This one's got some pouches on there, scraps of metal sort of stuck onto the leather armour. At some point this guy will make an appearance in my games, probably leaping out of a cave and attacking unwary adventurers. This is a double door from Mantic's excellent game, Dungeon Saga. Well, actually, I've got two of these. Nothing much to really say about these, but the bronze effect on the doors came out quite nice, and I'm rather pleased with them. Oh, and I trimmed the corners off the base to help them fit my dungeon walls a little better.
I think with it being painted bronze like that, it would make a very nice entrance for a crypt.
Next up, here's my Crypt Keeper, or Crypt Thing. I needed a Crypt Thing for an upcoming game, so I cobbled one together from a few bits I had lying around. This guy is mostly Frostgrave cultist parts, with a head from a Mantic Skeleton. It's an extremely simple kit bash, but it does the job, and overall, I'm rather pleased with it. I've mounted him up on a standard round base with added texture from a Mantic Dungeon Saga base. The colour scheme and the general look of the miniature is inspired by this picture from an old D&D manual. These guys are of course renowned for their magical powers, which allows them to teleport tomb raiding adventurers back outside the crypt again.
Mort's Miniatures vlog will return after this. And now back to Mort's Miniatures vlog.
Now these are my shamblers. Hopefully some of you watching will recognize these as monsters from Quake. These miniatures started out life as an STL file by a guy called Wari. I'll provide a link to the STL file in the description below. Now, I don't own a 3D printer.
That's not a 3D printer, that's the toaster.
Like I said, I don't own a 3D printer. So I got my friend Kat, who does own a 3D printer, to print these up for me. Now, these are resin prints and they were done on an Igloo Mars 2 Pro. I'm told that'll mean something to some of you watching. This first one is pretty much how it came off the printer. All I really did before painting was attach it to a customised base. But for the other three, I did some conversion work. To repose the shamblers, I cut them up with a razor saw. I then filed the joints smooth and round, and pinned the arms back on in their new positions. I then sculpted over the joints and attempted to match the muscularity of the original models. For this one, I raised the arms up into the classic shambler attack pose. I also decorated the base on this one with nails. This is of course a reference to the nail gun in Quake, which in turn is a reference to the band Nine Inch Nails that did the soundtrack for Quake, which you are hearing now. For this one, I brought the arms in close to the body for a more hunched over pose and shifted the weight onto one foot to try and make it look like it's walking. Painting these was simple but very effective. I started, as usual, with a black undercoat. I then built up through several layers of dry brushing to an off-white colour. I had the heat up in the flat a little too high when I did this and the paint came out kind of chalky on some of the layers, which left me with this grainy effect. But it kind of adds to the model. It looks like dry skin. Based on some rather nice reference images I found online, I added some fleshy tones to the stomach and towards the end of the limbs. I used various red washes and blood effect paints to add gore around the mouth, on the arms, and to the hooves. Are they hooves?
They're more like elephant feet.
At first I tried splattering the blood effect on using a stiff brush. This didn't work as well as you'd think, and for the most part, all these splatters had to be painted on by hand. To represent the Shambler's lightning hurling abilities, I added a lightning effect to this one. The lightning piece itself is from a very cheap action figure I found. When it came to painting, I added extra blue highlights around the lightning on the claws and the body to give it a glowing effect. Overall, I am very, very pleased with these. Quake has always been one of my favourite games, and I've always wanted my own Shambler miniatures, and these look just like they do in the game as far as I'm concerned. Here's Flaky Alpha Scale. This is a piece from Mage Knight Dungeons Trap Pack. Or rather, actually it isn't. It's actually a piece from a cheap action figure set that was entirely made of kind of recast Mage Knight pieces. Very weird thing I found in a pound shop years and years back. So yeah, this particular piece appears to be a kind of recast of the grabbing hand trap from the Mage Knight set. Here's a picture of it before I painted it. As you can see, they sort of recast the original design, then sculpted these skulls onto it randomly. I removed the four skulls from the base bit, and then re-sculpted my own base around what remained. I didn't feel brave enough to cut the skull out of the palm and try and re-sculpt that, so I left it as it is. It looks a bit weird, but I think I've got away with it. When it came to painting, I went for a sort of mummified flesh look, and use bone colours for the fingernails and, of course, the palm skull. That's a pretty cool piece. It kind of looks like it's bursting up out of the ground, ready to grab unwary adventurers. And here it is, with Lucky Alpha Scale. Yeah, not everything is suited to stop motion animation. This ruined building started out life as a failed print. Now, I don't own a 3D printer.
Mort, you've already done that joke, and it was rubbish.
Anyway, point is, Kat gave me this failed print of a cottage to see if I could do anything with it. I started by attacking it with a razor saw. I then took the chunks of corner I'd cut out and flipped them over and stuck them on top of the opposing corners. I used hot glue to fill in the inside of the walls, and then some filler to finish them off. The balustrade here is made from mat pins, lolly sticks, and a couple of wooden beads. This was printed on one of those filament type 3D printers, and to try and cover up that horrible layering effect you get from those, I sprayed it with Stone Effect Texture Spray Paint. I think this was, half successful. I guess the stones look like they're cut from some kind of sedimentary rock. The original floor looked pretty awful, so I covered it in filler, and then added flagstones made from an egg box. I'm rather pleased with this piece. It kind of reminds me of some of the ruins from Fable 2. Now, for the final bit of this video, what I wanted to show you was the terrain I'd made for the boss fight with the Demon General Prasnagar. But that game got cancelled, and won't now be held until well after this video has gone out. So, to avoid spoilers for my players, I'm instead going to be showing you this dragon. Now, while this looks like a nice old Citadel or Ralpatha dragon, it is in fact a plastic toy, based and painted up to use as a miniature. I've painted it as a red dragon, partly because that's what colour the plastic was, and partly because I hadn't done a red one yet. It's a pretty simple and straightforward paint job, nothing really to write home about, but it came out really, really nice, especially considering it started out life as a plastic toy. Now, My current players haven't actually encountered any dragons in my games yet, but this will probably see use as the dragon in The Warlock of Firetop Mountain, which I plan to run in my campaign eventually. As you can see, it makes for a good sized dragon when you get it on the table. Here's Lekiar for scale. And that's about it for this vlog. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel, and if you're subscribed to my channel, like this video. Until next time, I need a goodbye catchphrase.
Is that soup? You've got soup. Why didn't I get any soup?
It's coffee.
Why don't you drink it out of a cup like a normal human being?
Well, why do you wash up on occasion like a normal human being?
How dare you? How dare you call me inhumane?
I didn't call you inhumane. You merely imagined it. Calm down.
Right, you fucker, I'm going to do the washing up.
No, you can't. Listen to me, it's impossible. There's things growing in there. You haven't slept in 60 hours. Wait till the morning, we're going to tackle it together.
It is the morning, stand aside.
You don't understand. I think there might be something alive in there.
You mean a rat?
It's possible.
Then the fucker will rule the day. Christ almighty. Sin you with nicotine based. Keep back, the whole sink's gone rotten. I don't know what's in here. Shit.
I've told you, you've been bitten.
Burned, the fucking kettle's on fire.
There's something floating up.
Fork it.
No, I don't want to touch it.
But you must, that shit's gonna eat through the glaze. We won't be able to use the plates again. Get it with the pliers.
No, give me the gloves.
Ah yes, the gloves, you just won't touch anything without the gloves. What is it, what have you found?
Matter.
What is it? Where's it coming from?
Don't look, I'm dealing with it.
We've been in here too long. I feel peculiar. I think we should go outside.
Subscribe for Mort.